Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Music in the Atrium this afternoon. My name is Andrew Asenzo, and I am the artistic director of this program. And we're very excited to be here today because it's our first day back in 2022. So we're really pleased to be bringing live music back to the hospital. We have some wonderful performers for you today. We have Alex Toskov on the violin and Victoria Kogan on the piano. So without further ado, I'm going to pass it over to them. And please enjoy the next hour of music, and thank you for coming.
Hi, everybody. Thank you to Andrew for a lovely introduction. We are going to be starting with the Mozart Sonata K380 in E-flat major. And this is, again, another proof that Mozart preferred piano to violin. He gave many more notes to the piano. So it's pretty much a piano concerto with the violin accompaniment. So I hope you like this. This is a movement. There's three movements in this sonata. We start with a faster movement, then we slow down with the second one, and then we have a nice rondo, the third movement. Rondo means like a round thing, so it has a theme that repeats many times. And this is the one of those perfect examples of classical writing of the classical Viennese period. So here's a little bit of Mozart for you.
Thank you.
Thank you for your warm welcome. And we are very happy to play for you here. You can't see our faces, but we are smiling and having a great time. So hope everybody's enjoying their lunch or their nap or their afternoon little siesta. We are moving on to something much more dramatic now. And dramatic and Germanic. Johannes Brahms was a German composer who spent most of his life living in Vienna, the same place where Mozart lived. But a few or 100 years later. He composed three violin sonatas, and he also composed some cello sonatas, which are really wonderful pieces of music. So he wrote quite a bit of chamber music. He wrote four symphonies, and he was known to be a composer who destroys his work when he doesn't like it, and he was very, very picky about his writing and his music in general. So when he kept something, you know that it's good stuff. And in this particular case, this is sonata number three. This one has four movements, and they are very different in character. It starts with a very passionate first movement, goes into a much more relaxing second, then a very funny third movement, kind of like a scherzo type. Scherzo in Italian means kind of a funny situation, a joke, if you will. And then the fourth movement, which is just pure passion and very, very dramatic stuff. So, with no further ado, here's a little bit of Johannes Brahms.
Thank you.
Thanks for speaking with us for this little lunch concert. I would like to use this opportunity to thank Victoria for being here and playing for us. She's absolutely incredible. We played quite a few concerts together, and it's always nice to come back. And she's playing a lot of notes today, so she's really working hard and playing this absolutely incredible music of the past. I would also like to thank you all for being here and sticking with us, and to Andrew for having us here, Andrew Shenzo, the absolutely incredible cellist and organizer of these wonderful events at Princess Margaret. Thank you to the venue as well for having us, and everybody who's listening on all the floors and rooms, and I don't know, we probably have more audience that we can see.
Yeah.
So whoever we can or cannot see, thank you for listening and tuning in today. We are going to play one more piece for you, and we are going to stick with the theme of the Viennese music. And one of the absolutely most incredible violinists of all time was Fritz Kreisler. You might have not heard of him, but he was a virtuoso of the late 19th century, and he was absolutely a phenomenal violinist who was traveling all around the world and playing for all sorts of kings and queens and audiences, and taking a lot of trains at the time because, you know, that was the way to travel. So we're going to play one of his Viennese pieces called Liebeslied, or Love Sorrow. So we're going to end on a little bit of a sad note, but you will see the changes of moods in this piece because it goes from very, very sad to kind of optimistic and then back and forth a few times. So once again, thanks again for having us. We hope to be back to play for you again, and have a wonderful rest of your day.
thank you everyone so much for joining us this afternoon. I want to give another round of applause to our wonderful performers, Alex Toskov on the violin, and Victoria Kogan on the piano. Thank you so much. This is our first concert back at Princess Margaret after a long, long hiatus, so it's wonderful to be back and bring live music back to this space. We will be having concerts every Wednesday afternoon from 12 to 1 p.m., and they're also live streamed, so I'd like to welcome our live stream audience. So you can watch from home or from anywhere on YouTube on the Princess Margaret Cancer Foundation's YouTube channel. I'd like to thank the Tova and Solomon Spiral Family Foundation, who makes this concert series possible, and the Princess Margaret Cancer Foundation for all of their help and support. Thank you so much for joining us. Have a wonderful afternoon, a wonderful rest of your week, and we hope to see you for the music next Wednesday. Thank you.